Okay, we are recording, and I'm Julie Powers, and I am here in Farmington, Missouri, and I am so excited to be talking to Andrew Collier, my former classmate from Farmington High School, and Robert Berry, and these two amazing musicians are going to be in Farmington. Wonder of all wonders, why they're going to be in Farmington, Missouri, we're going to find out, right? On Thursday, October 24th at the Centene Center, right across from Farmington High School. And the doors open at what, 6:30?
Doors at 6, show at 7.
Shows at 7, okay.
So early show, we'll know it's Thursday. We know it's a Thursday night, and we know a lot of people have to work. And so doors at 6, the show's from 7 to 9, and people can be home at 10 o'clock and, you know, be ready for work the next day.
You know, I just think that is so amazing that we're going to have an actual rock concert that starts at 7 p.m.
I mean, on a Thursday
thank
night.
You. Thank you for those of us who go to bed early. You know, it seems to be getting earlier and earlier as the years go by.
Everywhere.
But we're really excited.
Eight.
Pardon?
Most of them start at 8, even all around the country.
I know, but what happens is the warm-up band starts at 8, and then the real people don't come on until like 10, right? And then I'm about to fall asleep by the time the concert's over. And then we have to drive home because it's never in Farmington. And this is going to be literally like 3 minutes from my house. So first of all, who is Andrew Collier, and why do we even care that he's coming home?
Why are you going home?
I don't know. Why are we doing this? So for those of you from the 80s, if you were around then, I went by Andy Collier then. And since the last 20 years I've been in New York, everybody started calling me Andrew. So that's what I go by now. But you probably know me as Andy Collier if you're from the area. And in high school, I was in band for 4 years, choir for 4 years. Julie and I were in choir together. That's kind of that geeky band choir music guy. I played basketball and ran track, but I was still the geeky, freaky, weirdo kid. And
some things never change.
I majored in music and pre-med in college. I went to chiropractic school. Kind of life took me that direction. I've been in practice for 25 years. But back in 2011, I was really actually quite depressed because the musician part of me was depressed because I wasn't doing it. And I really felt like that was something I always wanted to do. So right around the time I made a commitment to really get back into music and really focused on having a career in music, I met Robert through Ron Matthews. All roads lead to Ron.
All roads lead to Ron Matthews somehow, who was also a classmate of ours, right?
That's right. Ronnie and I were in Boy Scouts together since the sixth grade. Ronnie was in choir with us. And for those of you who may not know, our class of 1985 had at least 15 kids in the class of 1988. We all had younger brothers and sisters. You had Brad. I had my younger sister, Kimberly. Ron's younger sister, Rebecca, we knew her as Becky. Rebecca is now Robert's wife.
Yes,
that's crazy. So in 2011, when I made a serious commitment to get back into music, Ron said, hey, you got to go see this band, December People. They're going to be doing a show in Connecticut. I'm going to fly out and let's go to the show. I went to a December People show. I met Robert. I met Dave Med, your keyboard player. It's really
Ron brought Andrew to the show. And, you know, I've been very fortunate. I've worked with some really famous people, you know. So Andrew says, well, this guy must know something.
Yeah, you're kind of a big deal, Robert.
You know. You've been talking to my wife, huh?
Yeah.
But he comes up to me backstage and he says, you know, I want to get back into music. What do you think I should do? What would you suggest? I'm like, oh, another one of these guys, right? I mean, I love talking to people, but it's such a tough way to make a living. It's hard to break in. And here's a guy that's a doctor now. And he's had a great career as a doctor. He wants to break into music. What did I say, Andrew? I said, well, you have to write, you have to sing, and you have to just do everything you can do.
I said, okay.
And what do we... 8 years later.
8 years later,
he has done everything.
Right.
Numerous bands, and he keeps sending me these CDs of his music, and I listen to him. And I go, oh, that friend of yours from high school, Ron's a best friend. He's pretty good, you know. And I got another CD, and then I see a video, and I see this I go, wow, this Blu-ray, DVD, I go, wow, good performance. This guy's really good. And then I have this album that breaks out, and I say, I need a keyboard player of genius level. You know that guy you went to school with that I met? I'm only going to ask him. I'm going to ask him first, because I've learned the hard way. If you don't ask, the answer is no. So if you want somebody, you ask them and let them say no if they want to. Now, this guy here, as smart as he is, wasn't smart enough to say no. He said yes, because this is really hard.
Really hard.
Well, especially to take away that much time from your practice. You know, you have a thriving chiropractic practice, and now all these people are going to be in back pain by the time you get back.
He's up 2 hours before he goes to work practicing the music, and he's 2 hours at night after he's done with work. It's amazing.
It's a long day. You know what? We just started telling everyone in the office. We started telling everyone in June, look, I'm going to be gone. There's 52 weeks in a year, and I'm here 45 weeks a year. So I'm going to be gone for 6 weeks. We already did our West Coast leg, and then now we're out for another 5 weeks. And right now we're talking to you. We're in beautiful Montreal, downtown Montreal.
Yeah, nice here.
And so once this tour started happening, and just for if you don't know, if you love music of the 70s and the 80s and the 90s, you will love this concert. Music from Yes, Genesis, Steve Howe, Robert's back catalog. The new album that came out last year that Robert was making with the great Keith Emerson when Keith passed away. By the way, that's why the only reason I have this gig is because tragically Keith Emerson is not with us anymore. So I feel like I'm filling in, you know, because he's not available.
And you're capable.
I appreciate
that. You have to be capable to fill those shoes playing wise. So
when this album that Robert finished came out last year, it went to number one on Amazon in 5 countries on the first day, sold out in 5 countries on the first day, placed on 2 Billboard charts. And so once the tour got started, our manager got us a big leg that went, after we covered the East Coast, it went out like Cleveland, Cincinnati, Indianapolis, Chicago, Milwaukee. And I said, well, once we get to Milwaukee, we have to go to St. Louis. And then once we go to St. Louis, we have to go to Farmington.
Yes.
All roads lead to Farmington, right. And then it goes Nashville, Atlanta, Nashville, Atlanta, then we come to North Carolina, then we come back up to the East. But so that's basically it. You know, we're doing this show at the Centene Center. We're really excited. And we really want this to be like an 80s class reunion.
Right.
You know, We were freshmen, as you said before we started the call, Julie, that we started Farmington High School in the fall of 1981. We graduated in 85. We've got all the people we went to high school with before our younger brothers and sisters got there with us. And then all the people, you know, 86, 87, 88. So if you graduated anytime in the 1980s, you're going to have a great time. There's going to be a ton of people. It's going to be like a giant family class reunion from the 80s. You're going to love the show.
And forget all of that, what he said, because Rebecca's going to be there. Becky.
Oh, she is, because she told me she didn't think she could leave school at that time. So
she's a second grade teacher, and she's a fantastic teacher, but she said, I can't miss it. And I think it has something to do with the beautiful women of Farmington. I think she wants to make sure.
That's right.
Right.
I actually love it there. I've been there quite a few times now. Sang at my mother-in-law's wedding.
That's what I hear, but every time you come, I don't see you. So I didn't really believe you existed until
today. We're so busy. There's so much to do, you know, and I love it there. In fact, I think the music store is the Music Tree downtown.
It used to be Marlar's in Flat River.
Marlar's is in Flat River. And it's still open, but it's called Park Hills now because they combined all those towns over there. But it's Music Makers, downtown Farmington. And
I've been in there.
And you know, that's what happens when you've been out of high school for that long. You forget the names of things. but, you know, as much as we hate that Keith Emerson is no longer with us and able to create genius in the music scene, we are very glad that Andrew is part of your band and that somehow you guys were able to pull this together for Farmington, Missouri. And so, Robert, do you want to just take a real quick second just to kind of say, like, who are all of the other people that you have worked with? Because if I started naming them, I would get them wrong or I'd leave a bunch of people out. And I think that, you know, you haven't been like the out front guy a lot of times. Right. And so people might not recognize that name as much as they would recognize what you've done. And then they'll go, oh, that was him? Wow, he's amazing. Because you're a big deal.
Well, my wife, I know. She's been talking. I've been really lucky. I'm a songwriter, singer kind of guy with a recording studio. And I always say I get to do these things because I can, right? I worked, first of all, with Steve Howe from the band Yes. We had a band called GTR. And from there, I went to work with Keith Emerson and Carl Palmer and had a top 10 hit with a band called Three. Then Sammy Hagar called me, worked with him for 2 years, toured. When they were kicking him out of Van Halen, he said, they don't want me to use Michael Anthony on my solo shows. Would you play bass? I said, what, I say no to Sammy Hagar?
Right.
No.
Hey, of course. Sammy Hagar is like a big thing here in Farmington.
Oh, now that's a big thing.
You'll get more people coming because it was like, yeah, he was with Sammy Hagar, right? Probably.
Yeah. And, you know, I had a great time with Sam during those years. And even now, like if you've seen The Circle come through, when you hear the Van Halen songs and the keyboards come on, there's no keyboard player on stage. That's actually me playing the keyboards. They pre-record it and they play to the tracks. But anyway, gotcha. Sammy Hagar, then I joined once he got his own solo thing going again. I joined Ambrosia for a couple of years and toured with them. Biggest Part of Me. We're doing one of their tunes that I had an album called Life Beyond LA. And then when I thought, well, I think that's probably all the guys that I'm going to be working with now. What am I going to do? Greg Kinn called me. His bass player.
Ba, 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 ba. That is the right song, isn't it? Everybody knows that. Okay.
And I've been touring with Greg for 15 years. Again, we have a new album out a couple of years ago now, singer-songwriter with Greg, but it's the Greg Kinn Band. So I'm a good team player.
Right,
this
right.
New manager, and with the success of this new album, said, we got to put you on the road and do this under your name so you can play all your 30-year history of music. And I said, I'm not that comfortable with that, but I am comfortable playing the music, especially having someone like him that recreates Keith Emerson stuff, Jeff Downs, Jordan Rudess is with a band called Dream Theater. He's the best there is right now. This guy plays his stuff. And then we have our own stuff too that we're doing from the new album. It's just 30 years of great music. And I'll tell you, I did this tribute series. The reason we're saying they're gonna know a lot of the music too, there's a label called Magna Carta in the 90s that kept us kind of alive. And we did tributes to Yes and Genesis and Jethro Tull, Rush. And we're playing those songs I did on those albums where I did my own little twist to them. So you're going to know half the material that we play just because, you know. You won't know exactly how we're doing it. A little bit of twist to the beat, you're going to know it. And it couldn't be better. I mean, we're having great responses from the audience. We're doing lots of interviews, talking to all kinds of people. We have t-shirts and CDs and merch all over the place. It's really
if
fun.
If you live in the Farmington area, I have sent out about 150 posters. Surely someone may
and
have seen
it. And they look like this.
Yeah, right.
That's Robert Berry. And there's
I recognize him.
There's our little Andrew.
That's a bad hair day that day.
So you got Jimmy Keegan and Paul Keller with the band. And you're going to be here on Thursday, October 24th. If somebody wanted to get tickets, they would need to go to robertberry.com, follow
to
the link,
where to get them.
Right?
Yeah.
There's a link. You're going to wind up purchasing your tickets through a website called Brown Paper Tickets. A lot of people have purchased
them. I did.
Oh, thank you very much. If you go to robertberry.com, the tour schedule is there, and just scroll to the Farmington and click on the link and it will take you to the Brown Paper Tickets website where you can get your tickets in advance. And afterwards, there's going to be
$20 in advance and $25 at the door. Is that right?
$20 in advance, $25 at the door.
I mean, that's a total bargain, people.
Well, here's the thing.
Concert in Farmington.
It's costing us tens of thousands of dollars to travel all over North America. And we're coming to Farmington.
That's right.
So, I mean, just it's got to be within 12 minutes of where you live. So you should be able to get there. And
you were going to say something about after the concert.
Oh, the meet and greet. Free meet and greet. A lot of these places, too, when you go other places, there's a VIP meet and greet where they charge you like an extra $75 to $350 to meet people and sign autographs, whatever. Free. Stick around after the show. Pictures. You know, get Robert to sign posters and T-shirts and, you know, stuff. But we'll all be around, and it's going to be a great time.
Yeah, half of doing this, because I've been so lucky for the 30 years of working with all these guys, that we're not out there making a bunch of money and stuff, trying to, you know, gouge everybody. Like McCartney, $650 for the nosebleeds.
Yeah, that's crazy.
He doesn't have any money, poor guy. Anyway, yeah. I love him. But word out there to sort of thank people for supporting my music and giving me a career that's kept me going, and introduce Andrew to a wider audience, because he's going to do big things in his career. And that's important to me, being a Farmington kind of supporter that I am. So we don't want to charge much for tickets. And then,
no, you know, I think
we just want to shake hands and thanks people. Thank them for coming out.
Yeah.
You know, this is the first time that I have spoken with Andrew since what?
The graduation day, 85.
You were in Farmington a little bit.
Oh, in the 90s, right.
Yeah, right. So I did see you in the early 90s, but then you were mid-90s, I guess. And then you left and you like disappeared, and now here you are again. And I'm just so glad, because you were always such a musician. I mean, from day one, like the absolute best. And we always knew that if it was music, it was Andy Collier that was going to be at the helm. And nice. So to see that you've been able to go back and refuel that passion, because I'm all about people living their passion and their purpose. Mm-hmm. And you were here to spread joy through music. And so I'm so glad that you've connected with Robert. I'm so glad that Rebecca found Robert, and that everybody has come in alignment with Ron Matthews. And so when he sees this,
Ron,
we love you.
Ron found him.
And forced Rebecca to take my Facebook requests. So it's Ron that made that happen.
All right. All right. Well, thanks, guys. And I will get this out to you so that we can spread it far and wide and get a lot of people there that night.
We'll see you soon.
Thank you so much. All right, we'll see you later. See you.